Why do you think you're not writing?
I don't know. I get a good idea, and then, bam, I start thinking that is the stupidest thing ever.
Tell me about it.
This is the true and impossible story of my very great love, Ruby Sparks.
Calvin Weirfields is a novelist in his late 20s who, in his late teens, had a breakthrough bestseller novel and has never been able to follow up. So he's seeing a therapist who suggests to him that he write about someone who could love him completely.
I want to give you a writing assignment.
Can it be bad?
I'd like it to be very bad.
And he dreams up Ruby.
Have we met before?
Who is, to Calvin, a very real person, but the more he writes about her, the realer she becomes to him.
Ruby Sparks, 26 years old, raised in Dayton, Ohio.
Why Dayton?
Sounds romantic.
Which is actually not a good thing because she doesn't exist.
You're a genius.
I'm glad you found something that inspires her.
Inspires me. It's like I'm falling in love with her.
That's wonderful.
I can't fall in love with the girl I write.
Why not?
Because she's not real.
And then, you know, one day he wakes up and she's in his house.
I missed you in bed last night. Did you get some good writing done?
And he thinks that he's lost his mind.
Calvin, are you mad at me? Ruby Sparks, the girl, thinks that they have been in a relationship for about a month or two.
Remember how Dad used to say I had an overactive imagination?
You know, she thinks that they're in the honeymoon stage of their relationship, and he thinks he's going crazy.
Calvin, but there's no possible way that Ruby's in your house because she's not a real person.
And then he brings her out into the real world to prove that this is not actually happening.
Calvin, do you know this girl?
And other people can see her.
Can you see her?
Calvin!
And she's totally real.
She's real. Oh, no. Ruby!
He goes from thinking that he's crazy to realizing that this girl that he is in love with actually exists.
There's got to be some logical explanation.
People don't appear out of thin air.
She did.
How?
I don't know how. It's love. It's magic.
And decides to take that leap himself and embark on a relationship with her.
Have you tried writing more? Write something about her
and see if it comes true. If it does, this is a miracle.
That was insane!
You manifested a woman with your mind.
The story that we're telling, it is funny, it is romantic, but it also needs to have a reality to it as well. And we could not think of anybody better to handle that tone than John and Val, and they're friends of mine. We made Little Miss Sunshine together, and so I've been in touch with them over the years.
There's always something interesting behind the scenes.
What I loved about this script was that it takes this fantastic premise, but the forces at play are really ones that we all face every day, which is, how do I not seek to control the person I'm with?
He was such a control freak, right?
So we really loved it, and we loved Paul and Zoe, and it just seemed like this is such a sweet story.
What does Dr. Rosenthal say?
He'll think I'm crazy.
You might be crazy.
The situation is crazy. I am not.
Really? To believe in love, I think, is incredibly powerful and very, very difficult.
You may see this and think it's magic, but falling in love is an act of magic.
How do you accept a person for who they are completely? And how do you do that without saying, I wish that you didn't have this part or that part?
What are you gonna do, marry her?
I don't care. I love her.
That kind of love is what marriages are made of.
You don't know jet about women.
I know Ruby. I wrote her.
People like a good story, and I think it's a good story because you can really relate to what's going on.
Just don't tell me how it ends, okay?
I won't. I promise.